so we are ready to draw a cat. And we are going to make a big cat. And it's going to be about as big as this piece of paper. So what I want you to do is I want you to get the piece of paper that I sent to you in your packet. And that is going to be our background. Okay? And this piece of paper, just get a piece of printer paper. And this is going to be what we draw our cat on. All right, so first of all, we're gonna look at our picture right here, and we see what this cat looks like. It looks like a big heel. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw a big heel. All right, this should not be too hard. Whoops, my wall is kind of bumpy, so it's kind of making it bumpy. And we go down like this. I think I went too far down over here, so I'm going to erase that. I'll get my eraser in just a minute. All right, and then I'm going to draw a little U, and that's going to be its leg, and that's going to be the other leg. All right, can you see this? All right, let me go over it. Kind of darker. All right. So now it's nice and dark. You can see it. And then I'm going to do a big, I'm going to do a big U right here because that's going to be the middle of my cat. Big U. Now I want all the feet to be the same length from the edge, so that all the legs need to be the same. So try to look at that, and you may need to erase and go again. Like I'm gonna have to erase this line over here because it's too long. And then I'm gonna do another little U back here, upside down U. Whew, this wall is so bumpy it makes my paper get bumpy. Draw that leg. And draw that leg. Now I'm just going to erase this line over here when I get my eraser. All right, now the cat needs a circle for a face. So I'm just going to lightly trace the face out right here, and I'm going to do it darker. All right. So do you see where I put the face on the shoulder? That's kind of where the curve is. So that's where I put the face. All right. Now the cat is going to need triangles for ears. So I'm just going to do a triangle and a triangle. Those might be just a little small, so I'm just going to make them a little bigger. I think that one is a little tall. I just want it a little wider. All right, now my kitty cat needs some eyes. And so, you know, cats have like slits in the middle. So I'm gonna do a big eye there, and I want it to come over the same height, a big eye here. All right. There's the eye. Now I'm going to put the slanty parts. It's got to curve out in the middle and back down to a point. I'm going to color that in black. I can do it with a crayon too later. A little bit bigger. All right, it's kind of a leaf shape. Kind of a leaf shape. Oh, my cat's starting to come together. I need to see if I have an eraser in my pack. Let me go get an eraser from my desk. I thought I had all of my stuff together before I started, but I forgot my eraser. So we don't need to see his shoulder because his head is on top of his shoulder. So we're going to erase his shoulder. Okay, and that's what a lot of artists will do. They will erase the lines they don't need. So his head is in front of the body, so we can't see the shoulder. Now it doesn't make his head look weird. I'm going to erase this line over here. Now, if you have ever been around a cat, you know that their tail is very twitchy. So they did a tail that came up. So I'm going to do my tail to come as a big curve. All right. I just did it up, and then I curved down a little bit and back up. Okay. Now I want it to be getting a little bit skinnier as we come up. Okay. So the cat's tail needs to get a little skinnier as we come up. Okay. Come down and connect the tail a little better. All right. Now you might need to try this two or three times before you get it. You want to be sure that your cat comes all the way from here to here. Do you see how much space is left on the back of the paper? How much space is left at the front? The cat takes up almost the whole paper. And I want you to do a little tiny cat. I want it to be big because this is a cat picture. Okay? Now, one thing they did is they drew dots and some of the kids drew lines. So you can do whatever kind of pattern you want. I'm going to do dots on my cat. But I'm going to paint my cat first, and then I'm going to do the dots on top of that. So I'm not going to draw anything on my cat first. But you can do what, however you want to do it. You can go ahead and draw your pattern on there, and then you can just paint on top of the pattern. You can trace the lines with a crayon. Like, they did their cat in gray and gold. But I think I want to do my cat just like a make-believe cat. I just want it to be, like, cute. So I think I'm going to do my background in yellow, and I'm going to do my cat in pink. And I have to think about what color spots I want. I might put white spots, or I might put white stripes. But I'm not sure, but I'm just feeling a pink cat today. So you can do a teal cat, purple cat, gray cat, black cat. Do whatever color cat you want. All right, now let's finish drawing this face. Now they've got a little triangle, but the triangle is a little bit rounded on the corners. Okay, so that one is a little bit, you can't see that. A little bit round on the corners. Can you see that? All right, now then his mouth comes down. And then it just has a curve. And it has a curve on the other side. And that's his little mouth. Oh, he's cute. Or she, he or she. All right, can you see? Okay. And it's a little funny looking because the body is a little bit big for the head, but you know what? I'm pleased with it. So, I am going to paint this now. And I said I wanted my cat to be pink. So I need a paintbrush. I'm going to work with this size paintbrush. But it has, you know, it's pretty big on the legs, so I think this brush will be okay. When I'm up here, I'll have to turn the brush on its edge or get a smaller brush. Now, I really don't think I want those gray black lines to show, but I may have to put several layers of paint on there. But that's okay. I can do that. All right, so here's my paints. I have yellow, orange, red, and white. That's the colors I'm going to be mixing today. I'm going to do a double dip because that will add value. And just a teeny bit of red. And let's see how that does. All right, that's not quite dark enough. Get just a little bit more red on there. And we're going to cut out this cat so you don't exactly have to stay in the lines. All right. Looks kind of like strawberry ice cream. So my front leg is darker than my second leg, so I'm going to add some more red. That is so cute. All right. Oh, that's very red. Get a little bit more white. Ooh, I need a lot more white. I don't want it to be that red. I want it to be pinker. All right, and it's pretty easy to paint because it's a pretty simple shape. And I'm going to be cutting it out so I don't have to worry about staying in the lines too much. Don't leave any puddles. Don't get so much paint on your brush that you have to brush. You really shouldn't brush. All right, this paper is pretty thin, and that's why it is starting to wrinkle, because as it gets wet, it's going to wrinkle. That's okay. All righty. I'm going to try to do the belly a little bit wider, because you usually think of cats having a white belly. Need just a little bit more red over here. Too much paint on my brush. Okay, so how's your kitty turning out? Ain't my kitty turning out kind of cute? Alright, I'm going to try to do around the eyes. I don't want the eyes to get colored, so I'm just going to have to be very careful. Alright, I'm going to do the ears. I'm going to have to come back and get that a second coat because it's just not dark enough. All right, that's pretty good. It's kind of a light pink on the face. Oops, get in the eye a little bit. All around those eyes. All right, I have got me a pink cat. Hello, kitty. All right, I am going to let that dry. And then I'm going to cut him out. No, I'm going to cover him again. Because I think his parts of him are just too light. Okay. I'll come back and I'll do his face just a little bit. Oh, his tail. I forgot his tail. All right. I'm going to do the tail dark at the back of it. I'm going to do a darker pink. Enough paint on my brush to do this whole tail. Put my white up in here. Okay. Now I'm going to let that dry, and I will come back and I will do some more if I think it needs to be darker. I'm going to put this paintbrush in a jar of water so it can be rinsing. I'm going to get another paintbrush, and I want a big paintbrush. Let's see. Here's a big one. Looks like it might have some green paint left in it, though. I see some powder fluffing out of it. Sometimes you can flick them back and forth. If they didn't get rinsed good, there'll be like a colorful powder just popping out of it. All right, so now I'm going to color this. I want it to be a little bit peach. So I've got yellow, and I'm going to start with the yellow. Ooh, bright sun shining. See that? I'm just going to cover the whole thing. I had to get on my wall here. Whoops. It just dripped. No puddles. Don't do puddles. Spread it out. So y'all been doing this for a little while. You should know how to not do puddles now. Put a little bit of white in there at the top. I want it to be a little lighter at the top. I'm going to double dip my brush with some yellow and some white. Ooh, I like that double dipping. I wish I had done that everywhere. The yellow and the white double dipping. Leave streaks that are pretty. Oops, got on the wall. I'll have to clean that up later. Oh, this brush has got green coming out of it. I don't want green in my picture. So I'm going to try to wash it out a little bit. Well, that's a yellow cloud in my water. I'm just going to squeeze it. Squeeze all that water out. Here we go again. I want to get a little bit of orange in there and a little bit of red in there towards the bottom. Not a lot, just a little bit. Ooh, that looks like more than I wanted. In there. I don't know if you can see that little bit of streaking with a teeny bit of red in there. I kind of like it. It's kind of peach. We'll see. I can get a little tad of red on my brush. Maybe just a little bit more. What color did you decide to do your background? I can't wait to see what color you decided. Oh gosh, that's a lot of red. Whoops! I didn't know I had that much. I guess it is what it is. I wanted it to get darker as it goes down. But it's looking kind of weird. But I think it'll turn out good when it's all said and done. Just got one more corner. I wish I had some more white. I like the white in there. All right. think I'm gonna get just a little bit more white. And a little bit of white at the top. Ooh, I like that. Of course I would, because I always like white. So what color are you putting in yours? You don't want to get too dark. Although you can have a dark background, but you just don't want to just keep rubbing in all of the colors so that it just turns into one color. You want to see the different shades and the variants in there. Like this is light and that's red and that's a darker red. That just gives it a little bit of interesting texture. All right, now I'm going to put that brush in my water. And I'm going to get my pink brush back out. Okay, rinse that brush off good. It's kind of got a lot of color in it. Okay, squeezed it out. Now I'm gonna paint my cat's face just a little bit more because it looks really pale. And even though I want it to be a light pink, I want the color to cover. I don't want it to just show paper coming through. So I'm gonna get a little bit of, tiny bit of red on my brush and white. I don't have to worry about staying in the line so much. Why? Because I'm going to cut it out. Yes, I'm liking this better. All right, because his face is not so pale. And I'm trying to paint in a circle so that it looks different from the body. Body goes one direction and the head goes another. Whoops, got too much. All right, cute little kitty. Now I'm gonna paint the tail a little more because it's a little pale too. Just a little bit more red on the tail. Now you just kind of have to play with your paints a little bit. And I think when you first start painting, you're kind of afraid to do that. Okay. Kitty-witty. All right. I think my kitty is done. And I am going to let it dry for a little while, and then I'm going to come back and make the next video of me cutting it out. Okay, so we will come back in just a minute. And we will cut our kitty out, and then we'll add the dots or the stripes or whatever we want to do. All right, so there you go, a kitty and painted.